So, I saw this pop up in my recommended. It looks unique. The BGs sounds like this lip balm I use. Oh, it's called Burt's Bees. Shout out to Burt's Bees. I'm thinking of a lip balm. So the BGs, I think they're a pretty big deal. I've never listened to them. All right, I'm Gen Z. All right, like, you know, we don't really have music that is passionate and has like authenticity. We have auto-tune with garbage and trash and debauchery, just destruction and darkness, the synagogue of Satan. This song is too much of heaven. We have too much of hell. So hell. With no further ado, all right. Enough of this. No further ado, guys. You came to see a reaction, and I came to react. So. Make sure to smash that like button so more people can enjoy this content just like you. Thumbs up on the video. And subscribe to the channel. We are on the road to 20K before Christmas. That's the goal. We are what you call proactive, productive, and disciplined in these YouTube streets. I have to sniff my lemon-scented candle. It's got lemon in it. So, let's check this out. Too much of heaven. This is back when we were in a God-based society. I think. Sounds like baby making music. I love you. I sound good on the mic. All jokes aside, this is beautiful. Oh my God. It's much harder to go. Wow. I was not expecting that. Nobody gets too much love anymore. It's as high as wow. A mountain and harder to climb. Ooh, you and me, girl. I gotta ask. Did they have auto-tune? It flows through you and it flows through me and I love you so much more. Wow. Beautiful. It sounds amazing. I feel like I'm actually like doing a disservice by pausing the video, but I have to because YouTube is interesting. So, this had to be made back in the age when you could get married. This was made around like the boomers' time. It has to be. This was like back when you could start a family in America. Oh my gosh, like this music is back when like this sounds like marriage music, like let's light a candle and enjoy our sacred love and have a moment of intimacy. That's what it sounds like. You know, we don't have anything intimate in Gen Z. You know, the only intimate thing we got is our phones. We just intimate with our cell phones. That's the only intimacy we got is a heart emoji. That's Gen Z's form of intimacy, a heart. But no, this is like music like they played at weddings. It has to be. I mean, I never really been to any weddings. You know, people don't really get like anybody gets married these days. You know, in my generation has been divorced under the like the first or second year. So it's sad. But this song is beautiful. And shout out to the generation that was blessed with this kind of music in your generation. So. Whatever generation this was, I'm going to guess the boomers. You guys had it good. I'd be surprised if this is Gen X music. This is beautiful. Wow. I'm assuming this is their natural voices. Like no auto-tunes. No filters. They just singing on a mic. Amazing. This definitely has to be the 70s. This is beautiful. I gotta pause it. I got so absorbed into the song. Like, the song just, like, you just, like, this is, like, fall in love music. Like, you know, like, you know, let me, how do I want to word this? All right, I'll say it like this. So, you know what? I forgot what I was going to say. It's cool. So, anyways, around what I was going to say was, this is the kind of music that would make you want to go out and buy flowers. Like, you know how, like, men are dreamers, you know, granted women dream too, like, but like dudes, we can sit here and think about like somebody, granted, you know what, really boys and girls do this, but like I don't know if girls do this too much though, but like a dude, I know for dudes, we'll see it, we will see a girl that we like I did this when I was like 12. You'll see a girl that you like, and then you'll see your entire future with them, and you'll plan your wedding out. You'll plan like your anniversary, weddings, kids, vacations, the house you'll live in, the cars you'll drive. You'll have your entire future planned out. This is that kind of music. Like, you'll listen to this song walking down the street, and as you're looking at trees and houses as you walk down the street and the intersection, you're like, in your head, you're like dreaming about frolicking through flowers and sunsets and dandelions and doo-doo-doo and clouds and skies of sunshine and beautiful rays of light, angels singing in heaven. This is that kind of music. Absolutely amazing. Their talent is through the roof, though. Like, I have extreme respect for these guys. This is my first time hearing them ever, so it's like, wow. You know, like, I think this is like around the 70s. It's gotta be. It just looks like 70s graphics to me. No disrespect to anybody, but yeah, I don't really see how that would be disrespectful though. But yeah, man, you know, this is just amazing. And would this be considered R&B? I don't really think this is R&B. This is like, what? Like, what is this? This is not country. Like rhythm and soul. Like, is this soul music? Like, what genre is this? You know, like, what do I call this? Like, how do I categorize this song? And then on top of that, whatever category this song would be classified in, like, to me, I say R&B because, like, that's like love music, I would imagine. But nowadays, we don't even have that. We just have Delulu is the Salulu and all this foolishness with Insta. Let me stop. Anyways, it's the Wild West out here, but literally. But this song, man, this is definitely back when you could start a family in America. Shout out to whatever generation had this. These guys are rapping about women they loved, or a woman they loved. It's much harder to come back. I'm waiting in line. Nobody gets too much love anymore. It's as high as a mountain. This makes me feel like everything is going to be all right. Wow. Can we just appreciate that? Like, bro didn't say any words. He just said, oh, no, I got to sniff my candle. All right, it's got lemon in it. But, like, I just felt that in my soul. Pause. But it's just amazing. This is like when you sniff the girl at school, like your you know, high school crush. You finally get your high school crush, and then you sniff her hair. Jessica. I finally get to sniff her hair. This is how it feels when you have butterflies in your stomach. Like, this is how it feels when you finally kiss the girl at school that you've been, you know, drooling over. Finally get to kiss Jessica. Oh my gosh. this is when you guys consummate in marriage, or when you like first lost your virginity. Oh my gosh. Wow. He didn't say anything. He just said, I pray to God this video does not get blocked. Ripping it without saying any words. Oh my gosh. Wow. They had real people playing real instruments, like live. Like these ladies are on violins. This might be the 60s. But I don't really know what the 60s looked like, to be frankly honest with you. But hopefully this video doesn't get blocked. Wow. I'm just truly amazed. This was just like well worth my time, to be frankly honest. Like this song is like gold. Like if you could just make gold audible, this is that. Meaning if you could make gold, like if you could hear gold, this is the Bee Gees. So, wow. Truly extremely talented. Good Lord. You know, it's a bit of a shame I'm just now discovering them, but I'm glad I'm able to discover them and be able to comprehend what my ears were just blessed with. So, that's that. You know, that's my thoughts on this. I'm really amazed. What really got me, too, was like, bro literally said, ah, and he started hanging them notes, like hitting them notes. And it just went through my soul. And I was like, whoa, whoa, whoa. I didn't say I was ready to go to heaven. Too much heaven. He was like, ah. I'm like, oh, wait. Oh, shoot. He was just ripping it. I'm like, this is beautiful. Oh, wait. But, and it just, I just felt it. I'm like, dang. I'm about to make a brother shed a tear, man. It's like, no, I ain't shedding no tears on camera. I don't shed tears. But, yeah, man. Forget tears. Tears for fears. Yeah, this is just amazing. They got plants around them. Wow. Yeah, man, the way they dressed, it's kind of how my grandfather dresses. He's 93. That probably sounds absolutely terrible. I apologize. Like, I did not mean to offend anyone. I'm just saying, like if I could zoom in right here, which I can't, you can see my mouse getting like big. Pause. You can see this guy right here, the way he's dressed. That's exactly how my grandfather dressed. My grandfather used to have his chest out like that. He's been married. Like, let me stop. Anyways. So yeah, that's all for this video, you guys. If you enjoyed this content, make sure to smash that like button so more people can enjoy this content just like you right now. And subscribe to the channel. We are on the road to 20,000 subscribers for Christmas. Make sure to share this video, like, comment, subscribe, and comment down below some of your favorite BG songs that I can that you would like to see me react to, some other artists you'd like to see me check out, and where were you when you first heard this, and what was life like for you when you first heard this? I always say that because I like seeing everybody's stories, because my dad always says, music is like a time capsule. Like, you can listen to a song and remember exactly where you were when you first heard it. So, that's all for this video, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.